for a hot minute, you already know that we're huge fans of Curiosity Chronicles history curricula. This is completely secular, aimed for students from elementary all the way to middle school. And we have been using Curiosity Chronicles since the very first book release. The very first one, Ancients, it was in my hands the day it launched. Maybe not the day it launched, but you get the point. So I do have the brand new release, which was Snapshots of Modern History, Volume 1. I'm going to tell you all about it, going to walk you through what I have, but I'm also going to do a brief overview of all the pre-existing levels that we have gone through. I have individual videos on all this, but it was in my IGTV day, so I just think it would be beneficial this time to run down everything with you. Plus,
you look at me and see that I'm the type of girl you're not really that used to.
Welcome back, friends. If you're brand new to my channel, my name is Arlene with Arlene and Company. As I said before, I have the brand new Snapshots of Modern History Volume 1 to share with you today, but we're going to run down the complete program because no matter if you've never used it, curious about another level, this video is going to be for you. I graciously received this in exchange for my honest review, but you guys have been a longtime fan. I brought the very first one and then I've been partnering with her for the subsequent levels after that. So I'm very excited to share the newest release with you guys and give you some more information. So hopefully this will help you decide if this is the one for you. All right, so let's get particular to it. Edition is the modern history. So we are going to be covering in volume one from 1850 to the eighth of World War I in 1914. Volume two is gonna cover one and up to 1950s. Volume three is gonna cover 1950s to the early 2000s. There is no estimated release date at this time that I can offer you for volume two and three. So just know that. So with how this is set up, you can fully take on the whole year per volume and take up to 3 years to go ahead and complete modern history if that's your vibe. Let's say you're viewing this, you know, years later, you can find a way to condense it and do these three volumes, especially with a higher or higher level or older kiddo in a year. It's a lot, but it is possible. All right, so these are divided into 36 chapters in 18 sections. Let's briefly go over what has happened before this, before we get into that. Again, if you're interested in just this one, timestamps is down below. Okay, so this is the very first release, and this is important that I show you a couple of the different options. So this is the soft cover. This was like the smallest profile. These are print on demand, which means you have to give it, they say 5 to 10 days. I would just give yourself that buffer of the 10 days because when you order it, they're print on demand, right? So you have to wait a little bit. It's not like it's just in stock and it gets shipped to you. I've never had a problem getting materials from them fairly quickly. Their print on demand actually works really, really well. But here's your options. There's going to be a whole bunch of different bundles depending on which of the levels you want to grab, but they're all essentially the same type of bundles. You can get a soft cover or you can get the hard cover, and you can get this going along with your instructor guides and your student guides. And there's also audiobooks for the current available level of the modern history that is set to release with the guides in late summer. Okay, but there is a pre-sale with the complete bundle. If you know you're going to use all of it, that you can go ahead and buy the complete bundle and get the book, and then you will receive this when it releases. This is for a previous level, and then you could also do the audiobook. I highly recommend the audiobooks. There was a little bit of things, I know that they've been updating it. There was like a little bit of a sound issue on one of the levels, but I know that a lot of that stuff has been corrected. Again, we've been with them since they launched, so obviously there's a lot of growing pains and things like that. But even with those little issues that happened in the past with the audio, we greatly enjoyed it. I love the audio version for this because of the style of Curiosity Chronicle is a dialogue. So if you are, you know, homeschooling an only child, or you have kiddos that are not able to participate because this is above their level in reading, it always works really well if you have like, you know, a nice like family setup and and have people do different parts. If not, you can just read it as a narrative, totally fine. But it's really fun to be able to do like a collaborative effort and have your kiddos, you know, reading different parts. If that's not something that you think you can do or want to do, the audiobook, my friends, it's great because, you know, you have the voice actors. So
one of the things you can do is just go ahead and have your kiddos take turns reading these, right?
So different read the parts, because the dialogue's setup is really different. And some people love it and some people are like, yeah, but you know, don't knock it till you try it. But if you feel like you're gonna be someone that's just like, okay, I can't read it just like as a narrative form, which I think is very easy to do. You can just ignore the different parts and just go ahead and read. Or just, you know, switch your voice up, practice your voice acting skills. But if that's something you don't want to do the audiobook, friends, because the audiobooks is really nice. It's really fun. They're animated. You can slow it down, speed it up, whatever is your vibe.
And we're the founding members of the Curiosity Club.
I'm the president because I've read all sorts of books about history.
And I'm the vice president because I was the second person to join the club. I haven't read nearly as much as Mona, but I love to learn.
One of the bundles includes the audiobook or things, you know, you can go ahead and get it a la carte. You could also do mixed media. You can do a lot of these things in PDF if that's more your thing. Especially some families like to do the PDF of the student guide, and things like that. All condensed into 1 year. And after this one, they just started doing the volume ones and twos and all that. I will link my Instagram playlist of my previous videos. These two I did in one video. If you want to just see more in detail one's particular level, you can go ahead and do that. But we're going to briefly go over table contents and give you a brief look. So in the ancient history, you are going to have the 36. So it's already divided into like 36 chapters, so 36 lessons to can be completed over a year. Stretch it out, condense it however you want.
Introduction to the parents. You have the introduction to the characters. There's some fun like puppets that you can also get from them,
which is like, you know, if Mona is speaking, then you have you can put up like the Mona flag if you're the one reading the different voices and stuff. And then you can like put up if Ted is speaking. And then as you go on, you'll see that new characters are introduced, which is really, really fun. You can read all the table of contents right on their website.
You'll notice that the author's name looks different from the previous level, and she decided to switch by what she goes by, but it is the same author, just so you know.
But there's a note from her. Her page is very great as well for extra information and help, and you know how she viewed and developed the program if you want to go ahead and do that. There's also a Facebook group for people that use Curiosity Chronicles, which could be very instrumental, especially if you blend resources like we do. And there's just a fountain of great info in there. So here is like just instructions. Introductions to history is cool. And just to give you a thing, I know that I said it's geared for elementary to middle school. Each volume has a target age range for it. Know that also if you have a much older child, you can also use this as a springing off point where they can go ahead and read this for themselves and then use it as a tool to go ahead and do further research. Volume one is intended for
ancient history. One is the target range that this was written as for is first to third grade. So kinder, I mean, I would just say tag along, but a lot of this stuff may be over their head. But I do believe that is true as someone that did all the levels. Ancient first to third grade, I think that's very fair. They do also focus a lot on innovations, discoveries, and inventions and things like that in Curiosity Chronicles. So I feel like it's well balanced, and I love that. It's not all about just like wars and things like that. Though Ted loves his war facts, but it's not just singularly like focused on that. They really do explore a lot of the cultural elements and discoveries and inventions. You have like these timelines that go across, and you'll see that across across the levels. And there is also you know, kind of like a book a century timeline thing that you have like little icons that you can go ahead and do. And if you use the school mess notebook, you can use those icons there. They also have like escape room for really fun. So you have these very beautiful, vivid pictures. So I feel like even if you do an audiobook, don't skip on skip off from getting the physical book as well. So you can get the book in PDF. Let's say you know for sure you're just going to do audio, but you want your kiddos to be able to see the images and pictures and everything throughout. This is very vivid illustrations and pictures of maps and everything. You know, the different places, like, you know, they're having like a virtual tour. There's, you know, want to know more to encourage them to dig in deeper. Again, there's just a lot they can do with that. So I will show you the guides of how they are set up when I get to the level that I pull. I have the guides for everything before this, but I didn't pull it for every single level or my stack would be like way high. So that is ancient history. And again, you have focusing on Egypt, Mesopotamia, India, China, Greece, Rome, and a few extra stops in the America. Because I was like, I want the hardcover. I don't know why. I mean, the soft, like you can see, this is a few years old and it's perfectly fine. And my kiddos took turns like reading it and stuff. So it was handled by little hands. All right. So modern history, it gets quite a bit of a jump. So this is recommended for second to fifth grade. I even say that with medieval, you can even consider this for early middle school too. And if you have older children, it could be, you know, something that you add to it. Of course, especially like if you're using this for eighth grader or something, you're gonna want to add. All right, so this is the same. So it keeps it nice and predictable for you. So you know what to expect. It is divided again into those 36 chapters. And so you can do it over 36 lessons. If you choose to do one chapter a week, you can stretch that on beyond that. There's always an introduction to that history point. And again, we did the audiobook with this. See, this is why I would not skip getting the book, even if you just get it in a PDF format, because you want them to see the images. So you can see the dialogue going on. This is Mona, this is Ted, and so on. And it's very easy for you to just like bounce back and forth with your kiddos. So that is medieval history of what that looks like. You have the, again, the want to know more. And then they give them like, try researching the following topics: history of coins, trade routes and the Red Sea, history of Yemen, you know, and so on. So they have quite a bit. And then you also have the timeline going down and across that you can continue working on your book of centuries or timeline book of whatever you want to call it. And the teacher guys, the instructor guys, to really make it a full curricula. Because here is basically just a text. Here is your spine. But you're not going to have any of the instructions or anything like that of what to do with this information. Unless you just feel like, okay, you already have that from another curricula. I would recommend getting the instructor's guide, and I'll show you why. So medieval, you're going to be with Ted and Mona stops around the globe, like Imperial China, the Holy Roman Empire, the Aztec Empire, the Islamic Empire, Ghana, Japan, and so on. Introduced to the twins, leading an author. They have a bigger part in the next volume, but you do get introduced to this element, and then this element is expanded with focusing on the arts parts of going along with the histories in different points. And then what's cool about it is that you get like a little preview of it in this tight in this volume, and then you see more of them in the next. Okay, so that is the medieval history. This is early modern history volume 1 and volume 2. This is much larger profile than the medieval history, and that's because I changed it up to splitting it up. But then now I'm going to show you what the guides look like. So because that's the one I pulled from all this, all these different ones. So the early modern, it's recommended for grades 3 to 6. Again, you can stretch it beyond that, as long as you add, you know, a little bit of materials to make it, you know, maybe more research based or things like that, that they can dig deeper. You have the same 36 chapters, but they are divided into 18 sections, right? So the way you can do this can be varied. You can try to fit this volume into one semester. So do the 36 chapters in one semester, and it's divided into those 18 section, which will give you that one semester. If you don't want to condense it that way, then you can spread this first volume out into a year. But let's say you don't want to do early modern history for 2 years. Then it's set up into the sections so that you can go ahead and split volume one semester, volume two, the second semester. And also, I feel like that was also done because this is the spine that is used in Torchlight, and that's how their levels are set up. All right, so you have, and each one has two chapters in it, and then you have what's called the culture corner, and that's how they change. So you have the introduction again, and now you have a bigger presence from the with the culture corners. So you have that same setup with the dialogue. As you can see, the timeline is the same. So this is just going to depend on what point of history you want to do and what your, because most of the time your older kids have already done ancient history at least once or twice or whatever. So, are you wanting to focus on early modern? Are you wanting to focus on modern history? And that's really what is going to depend on what level to get, because, you know, the grade's different with the last few levels are not that big of a jump. All right, so you have the want to know more part, and here's the culture corner that we talked about. So here is where they're going to have a bigger focus on the arts, even though it was done as well in the first two levels. This is going to have that bigger focus with this part. So for here, for example, is on William Shakespeare, and they dive in deep on there, and then they go to the next section. Here's the culture corner that really jumped on us. Because, you know, we're Caribbean. So Caribbean music and dance. So I love how it's balanced. Yes, you're learning still about the wars. Yes, you're learning about the influences. Yes, you're learning about, different points of history and different historical figures. And that's true with every single level. You have several stops all over the globe. So you're bouncing between what's happening in those time periods all over the globe. Volume one. I also have a volume two, but you get the instructor's guide. So the instructor's guide, and now you can imagine the same setup or the similar setup for the modern history that I'm going to show you today. I don't have that in person to completely confirm that, but this will give you an idea of what it's gonna, the setup of what it's gonna look like. All right, so you can get it in PDF form if you prefer it, or you can get the physical books. And these, as last I checked, are only come softbound, which is perfectly fine. So it's divided in the same sections. You have general book recommendations. You have a sample schedule here. You have, on this part, you're going to have a focus on people, places, and things, comprehension questions, what do you think questions, timeline dates, map board coloring pages, reading suggestions, cross-references, hands-on activity, and the Minecraft challenges. This is something that always jumped at us. This is one of the main things that my kiddos really, really enjoy. The Minecraft challenges, you guys have heard me talk about it several times. That is going to be in your instructor's guide. There's always some confusion. Is it in this book? Which one do I grab? It's in your instructor's guide. That's where they're going to be having a Minecraft challenge. So you would build a separate world and call it history or whatever you want to do. And then the assignments, they can build it into that world. So that is a cool multimedia element of Curiosity Chronicles, which I really appreciate. Then you have review materials, answer keys, and all that jazz. And then the student guide, you have the corresponding chapters, vocabulary words, the comprehension questions, the list of timelines, instructions for the map words, additional activities, word searches and stuff like that, if that's more your vibe, a map of the chapter, a coloring page for each chapters, and so on. And you have a sample schedule here. So if you still can't visualize how you're going to break this down, they will go over that with you. Then they have some general spines or additional book recommendations. Know that there is additional book recommendations per section as well. And they will go over that to you. So here is some sample special schedules for two short sections, 15, 30 minutes per week. Here is if you can devote, this is a really awesome thing because you can decide, okay, yes, I can dedicate 45 minutes to this in two parts of my week, or no, I can do one long session, or I can do this much section. And you can see what your schedule will look like depending on how much time you can devote for that. So I really appreciate these sample schedules. So the long schedule, schedule per week, and then short sessions of how you would divide it by day is also gone over in there. So You have a planning guide that you can use to map this all out, to map out what supplies you're going to need, what supplemental reading choices that you're going to add from the things that are suggested, and so on. And this is also divided by the sections, and then a separate little line here for each of the chapters. So even if you're condensing and having it, the chapters are long, I'm not going to lie to you. They get longer going on, but they're not like painfully long to me. To me, it's a good balance. All right, so here, for example, is your first section. So you have people in this chapter, and that is nicely highlighted on here. It gives you a short little blurb on each of the historical figures that are being dealt with in that section. And then places. So you can go ahead and look at the map ahead of time if you want to, or while you're doing it. Things in this chapter, so you have, you know, Tudor dynasty and stuff like that, because is referenced with that, with this particular area. And then comprehension questions, what do you think questions, and then here are the timelines. So you don't have to go back and forth flipping through your text trying to find the timelines and what page was that in. So we can do that. It's all right here in your instructor's guide. And then here we'll designate if there's any map work or not. And then the coloring pages of what it would be. And then here, again, is chapter 2. And then you go from there. So section materials. So here is where you really can expand it if you're like a book basket folk, or if you want to add a lot of literature to it, you can really, really expand it. So here is divided. This is really, really cool, because if you're doing this really like family style, you can go ahead and tailored to different additional supplemental reading, wide ranges of ages, because you have picture books, and picture books, I'm sorry, they're good for even adults, okay? So you have here picture books, and she gives you a blurb about it, right? It's not just a listed of a word and that's it. She gives you a word about it. Informational books, chapter books, so you can get a nice good idea of what you're looking at before you like request from the library and things like that. And then here is going to indicate some cross reference if you're getting those additional encyclopedias, and it's going to tell you what page to look for to read for that particular one. So whether you're using the Kingfisher History Encyclopedia or the Usborne Encyclopedia of World History, I have both because I'm extra. Then hands-on activities. This is where we'll break down any art projects or experiment or whatever you are going to be doing. And this is, I will tell you, this is an advanced level skill if you want to go ahead and do something like for my kiddos, for my daughter, she would do like an advanced art skill as well. Additional activities. Again, so you can get a good idea of how much this builds on to the text. Like to me, if you are doing this as your curricula, you really do need the instructor's guide to really bring it as a full curricula and not just a reading element. Here you will find your Minecraft building activity. So it will be after in that section of four of those chapters. And then it goes on for here, the next chapter, the reading selections, and it continues on like that, okay? Then you have the answer keys in the back. So if you have those comprehension questions and stuff like that, you don't need to go ahead and try to go back and look at your reference and see, you know, if it's the correct answer or not. The answer key is all included in your handy dandy instructor's guide. Now, what changes with the student guide? Here we go. All right. So what's in your student guide? You have the maps, vocabulary exercises, the comprehension questions, the activity pages, the puzzles, coloring pages, games, and more. So let's take a look. This again is from the same volume one, Arlene Modern History. And again, you can imagine the similar setup for the modern history that has come. I like to keep these hard copies to eventually gift forward and, you know, just give it on to another family locally or whatever. So I like for my kiddos not to write on this. So what is nice, and I think it was like the early release a part of it. I had the PDF for it, so I can print for both kids the parts that we're going to use. We didn't use absolutely every single part, but we had these sections that I can go ahead and print them for them, and then I kept these books you know, blank. So I can pass it on. And again, you have all the questions and things that you saw on there, but now you have a space to put that. But for us and these type of maps, they would like paste it inside either back then was a main lesson book and not the school nest notebook, but now we would do it in like the school nest notebook if that's something that we were going to do. But anyways, you can see everything here, topic reviews, maps, the drawings, the word search, the crossword puzzles, and all this. So this is like their student workbook, all right? So all that information is going to be found in here, okay? So that's where you decide which one or if you need both, okay? So just briefly so you can see, because we're, you know, we're showing you all the volumes. This is volume 2, where this one picks up, where volume 1 ended. And it's the same breakdown. You have the sections, but it picks off from the other one. Now, I know I'm going to be asked, if we already covered the time period that is in volume 1, can I just jump into volume 2? Yes, you can. Just know that the chapters, don't be like, okay, what am I missing? Because it says chapter 37. It's going to pick up from there because it's going to assume that you already did this chapter, this spine, and you're picking up where you left off. Especially if you were doing this in combination with something else, you can go ahead and see that. So United States expands, Europe begins to modernize, Latin America revolutions, empires in Africa, natives in North America, and then, you know, just about bouncing around to different parts of the world, depending on the time period. Again, you're going to see the culture corners throughout. Really helpful charts throughout. Again, I would just like, I always hear people say sometimes like, oh, I'm just gonna do the audiobook because I can't do the dialogue style type of thing. Get the physical book, friends, because you're gonna be missing out on so much if you don't, right? So get the physical book, even if it's just in PDF, because as you can see, look how much is on the actual pages, right? I love this. Take a nice look at the newest release. So right now, your instructor guide and student guide and audiobook would be on pre-sale. What is available to grab now is the actual text. So this is the soft cover that I had here that she sent me. And this is volume 1. And let's recap. Volume 1 is 1850s to the eve of World War I. All right, so these I've always found pretty easy to work in. And again, globally minded history. And this is recommended for grades 4 to 8. So if you have been looking for world history and nothing has clicked for you for your middle schoolers, you guys know that that's what I share a lot about here is middle schooler, is this volume, and especially if you have not hit this historical point, is meant for fourth grade and eighth grade. And the reason being, and you may think, okay, well, I want to do a different historical point or whatever it may be. The language, the complexity and things like that, I find that it does definitely increase every single level. So I do feel that that range is true to what is stated. Again, you have the introduction to the modern history. You have the different sections. This is 18 sections, 36 chapters, same set setup. All right. And then you have still your Mona. This is Ted. This is author, and this is Lily. Yeah, you still have the culture corners that are going to be woven in between chapters as is relevant to different points. But this one, you know, welcome to modern history, and they're just very animated, things like that. Again, I find that if you don't want to, like, switch off and have them actively participate in the readings, or if your child is reading this on their own, it's no big deal to just read it as a narrative form and just ignore author. You know, it's like just like reading a play. So to me, it's basically like you're reading a play, you're reading a script. I think it's just so different that it's fun, and it's just not, you know, these longer drawn out chapters. It kind of gives you a break with the different voices and different personalities, and especially someone like me, ADHD, my kiddos are ADHD and autistic, they really find these parts really so fun. This is the only, I've got this, I don't know, maybe a month or 2 months ago, and I've been looking through it. This is the only level that we have not done. I don't have slotted to do modern history this year, But I may pick this up at some point intermittently with what else we're doing instead of holding off for the following year. I'm not sure. It's like itching at me because when it's there and I'm like, it wants me to use it, but I already had like a plan of what we were doing. So I may pick it up this year, part of it, or I may wait altogether for a following year, but this is the only one that we have not done. I've read through it already. I was reviewing the all the elements and stuff like that to share with you. Let's say they see something or an image, or here we'll in the caption and we'll tell them where it is. They can go ahead and research that place further, find out more information, and go into deeper dives. So I always find that extremely beneficial because it gives them an avenue to dig in deeper. Here's like talking about the political cartoons and want to know researching the following topics. So, the periodic table, the 1860s Oxford evolution debate. So these are heftier topics, especially let's say you're using this one family style, but you have a much older child tagging along. Take a look at these want to know more things, because this will seriously make it super easy for you to expand it for an older child, because you can have them write a research paper on this. You could have them do, a hands-on project. You can have them do all kinds of things based on these topics alone. But again, I highly recommend that you get the instructor's guide to really make this a full curricula instead of just a textbook that they're reading, which to me, this is not like a textbook because it's fun. I mean, some textbooks are fun though. You guys know that, that I'll tell you that every single day. So you still have that timeline thing. They have escape rooms for other levels. I hope they continue to expand the escape rooms. I think those are super, super fun. One of the things that I did not talk about is the Lapbook element. They have Lapbooks in storage, but that is something I've shown in the past where you can have the whole notebooking, and you can actually do the notebooking with the answers already pre-printed or have it blank. So you would choose the one that fits your kiddo based on their abilities of where they're at, and you can make it easy for them and have the answers already printed, but they're forming it and matching it up and everything, and doing a interactive notebook. It's so, so fun. We did it with every single level that we completed, and we love it. All that stuff is in storage because I'm required to keep records of evidence of our work and things like that for 2-3 years. So I think that's a fun thing. And if your kiddo is not like, your more workbook type style, I would highly consider doing the interactive notebook as a point of, comprehension or things like that, or return demonstrations. But remember, history, especially in the younger years, is all about exposure. They're not really expected to master it, but it's about exposure, and they're going to be exposed to it over and over and over again, especially with us homeschoolers. We love our history, don't we? All right, so... again, I highly recommend those interactive notebooks. They are beyond fun, and it just makes like a cool little element and a keepsake for you as well. And it's a great thing to add as a portfolio because y'all, if your evaluator, if you're like us, looks at that, our evaluator always got excited when they saw my kiddo's interactive. And to recap, you have things that makes Curiosity Chronicles different from the rest. You have the dialogue format. You have several different styles to really amp this up. You can do your hands-on activities. You can do vocabulary sheets. You can do questions, comprehension questions, additional books, review materials. You can do mapping. You can do interactive notebooks. You can do escape rooms. Hopefully they'll do an escape room. Like, this is me telling you that I really want them more escape rooms, okay? There's just so many things, and the projects are also really, really fun. You don't have to do it all, especially if you feel it's overwhelming to do that many or so many components for history. You do not have to do it all, friends. You can pick and choose from the different activities and things like that. But again, that's a big difference. You can purchase these in different bundles, whether you have a soft cover, the hard cover, you have PDF, or you have it printed, you have mixed media package. Maybe you want this printed, but you want the guides in PDF. They offer it all. And don't forget about the audiobooks. Any questions you have, again, we have completed every single level except for the one that just came out, obviously. But we have been using Curiosity Chronicles since the day it launched. So I am happy to answer your questions. Leave a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe and hit thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And I'll see you guys next time. The hard way. I've been taking every cup of coffee black now. Sugar coating everything.